Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Here in Israel, united in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Michael chapter 2 verse 10 real quick.
Bring it up.
Y'all want perfect conditions in a land that enslaved you. You all literally want the people that put chains on your back to treat you like friends.
That's right.
You've forgotten the start of the problem.
That's right.
You've forgotten the reason why you're being treated like this. That's why you think that the ways that you're in right now are wrong.
That's right.
Guess what? They've never forgotten who they have enslaved.
Right.
They know that you're the Israelite people of God.
That's right.
That's why they do the things they do to you.
That's right.
The only power you have is to keep God's ways in
peace. That's right.
Keep God's ways in peace.
That's right.
But you don't want to try that. You want to fight a man that makes the guns. You want to fight a nation that makes the guns. You want to fight a nation that makes the bulletproof vest.
Right.
You want to fight a nation that sets up things against you in the land. Right now, even amongst this crowd, you have co-conspirators. You have provocators to incite the riot even more. To what avail? To make the black man look like a super predator. You causing more harm right now than good.
That's right.
And the only solution that you have is what we've been reiterating. Keep God's commandments. Even right now amongst this crowd, you have provocators. You have people that will incite the riot even more. You have conspiracy theorists. You have people that don't care about Black Lives Matter. They only care about their lives and what they can do to profit off of this situation. You have many opportunists amongst this crowd. And it's not going to work. Thus said the Lord God.
Read on, come on.
Micah chapter 2, verse 10.
America is not the promised land. So stop thinking that it's going to be perfect. Change your ways and perfect your nation. Why do you think in the land of your captivity you're going to be treated like the best commodity in the land? You are not slaves. You have been driven to think that you're slaves. You are the Israelites. Slavery isn't all in our history. That's a pivotal part in our history because of our own disobedience.
That's right.
Read that again. Come on.
Micah chapter 2, verse 10. Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
The Lord said, come out of the ways of America. Come out of the philosophies of Africanism, of Egyptology, of Mormonism, of Catholicism. Come out of the ways of Christianity. Read that again from the top. Come on.
Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
The Lord said, this is not the promised land. This is not your homeland. Your homeland is Jerusalem.
That's right.
You've been lied to for years. They've keep clothed lies on you for many a year.
That's right.
Read that again from the top. Come on.
Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
This land of America is not your rest.
Right.
This is not the promised land.
Right.
Brother, real quick. We really think that we're going to be seeking peace amongst our enemies. You really think that these nations have compassion upon you? And when they blow tear gas and shoot at you, you act like the victim. Read that again from the top.
Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
The Lord said, this is not your rest.
Right.
If you really want change, go to the black communities and tell them to change.
Right.
March in the black community.
Right.
The police office, they're doing their job.
Right.
They try to nation of Israel.
That's right.
Plain and simple. We're here to serve you in God's commandments. We're here to serve in God's commandments and protect you under the shadow of the Almighty God.
That's right.
That's the only way you're going to have protection. Ways that you're choosing is not the solution.
That's right.
Read it again. Come on.
Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
This is the root of the problem of our nation. Give me Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17, real quick. Give me Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17.
Come on, teach.
Read that. Come on.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
You want to know the root of the problem in our communities? Hear evil from us, but we ain't about the hate. The problem of our communities is we have hatred amongst our nation. You don't want to change. You don't want to change. A lot of y'all are driven off your emotions. A lot of y'all can't think past the anger that you're in. Read that again. Come on.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
Black man, black woman, Latino man, Latino woman. The Lord said, you shall not hate your brother in your ways. Plain and simple. Plain and simple. Read on, come on.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
Do what?
Rebuke thy neighbor.
The Lord said you're supposed to rebuke your neighbor.
That's right.
Rebuke your neighbor.
Right.
Right now you have the proper authorities arming themselves right now. And you think you're going to win. You think you're going to win. You think you're in the right.
Right.
But you're choosing the wrong fashion.
Right.
God's commandments is the only way. All of this right now is emotion.
Right.
It's impulse off of what you see.
Right.
Read on.
And not suffer sin upon him.
Right. Read.
Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
Read it again.
Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
You got to concern and worry about your own race first. You live right now is the life of the so-called blacks and Hispanics, the life of the Israelite man.
That's right.
You are very, very valuable, not on this planet, but to God. What's your name, my brother?
Joseph.
I'm Tazawan. How you doing? Why is the black man right now being targeted? What do you think?
Because we're powerful.
Because what?
Powerful.
You're absolutely right.
That's
and I'm going to show you that power in the Bible.
Right.
Not because a man says it or it's a good idea or it's inspiring. God said so.
That's
your creator said so.
Right.
Do you know that Jesus Christ looked just like you, according to the Bible?
Right.
These are the lies and philosophies that this world upholds to keep you down low. That's why we're plagued in society.
Right.
They don't want you to realize the power that you have.
Right.
But check this out. Your power in the old ways of marching. What has that gotten us? Look at Jesse Jackson. Where is he at? It's been about 3 weeks now. Where are our leaders at?
Come on.
Our so-called black leaders at?
Come on.
You know what God's leaders are? Right here. We're looking at them. And we get this all from the Bible.
That's right.
It's only going to take another so-called black man to teach another black man how to do right. Why is that? Because I know the conditions that you're in. I can sympathize with you. I know what you're going through. Because we've been through it. But we've changed our ways. This violence and all what's going on through the world, guess what's going to happen? It's not going to change. Read this Bible. Come on, let's go.
Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15.
Hey, big bro. Come on, real quick. Read this. Come on.
And I will give you pastors according to mine heart.
The Lord said, I'm going to give you leaders according to his heart, his mind, his understanding, his ways. Hey, brother. Come on, read that again.
And I will give you pastors according to mine heart.
Hey, come on here real quick, my brother. Come on, real quick. Read that again. Come on.
And I will give you pastors according to mine heart.
Hey, it take one soul of 1,000 to change.
Right.
I'm telling you straight.
That's right.
The Lord called each and every single brother up here to make the real change.
Right.
How long we been marching?
Right.
How long we been protesting?
Right.
You come from the blood of the people that's been protesting.
Right.
That's why you here right now.
Right.
And the conditions that we in have not changed, man.
Yeah.
They ain't changed, bro.
Come on.
So when you gonna make that change?
Right.
When you change your communities.
Right.
But I'm gonna tell you straight, you gotta stop the pollution.
Right.
You gotta put the weed down.
Right.
You gotta put the drunkenness down.
Right.
And come back to your God and your ways.
Right.
Your God look just like you.
Right.
God is black.
Right.
And these things are happening to you because he's punishing his children.
Right.
He's punishing his children that are disobedient, bro.
Right.
You understand that?
That's right.
You said you follow us already. You already have a strong idea of what our lives are like in this world, right, brother? What's your name, man?
Judah.
Okay, Judah. That's perfect. All praise to the Most High. A Judah, brother. So I'm going to show you something in the scriptures. Your steps to your God. Your connection to your God. Because the Lord said this. Gather yourselves together. But we're not going to gather in marching of a vain thing. We're going to march under righteousness. Under right. What does that mean? I'm going to seek the best in you like you should seek the best in me. I'm going to look out for your family like you should look out for mine. That's the real love and change that's going to happen in our communities. Not the murder. Not the thugs. Not the weed smoking. Now we know we come from that lifestyle and that kind of things because of slavery. Slavery taught us how to be like this. The so-called Negro was made in America. We were never like this in our ancient time. We ruled this planet. Why did we get on the bottom? You broke God's commandments. Read that. Come on.
Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15.
Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 15. I'm going to show you. Why did we lose them ways? Just real quick. You understand that already in Deuteronomy. But listen, our people need to hear that we lost our ways and our connection with God because we transgressed. So only you're going to be the one to fix it. Come on, let's go.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
God said, if you don't listen to my commandments,
to observe to do all his commandments,
to keep his ways, come on,
and his statutes
in your community, in the black community, you got to keep his statutes. What are some of them statutes? How about rape? That's rampant in our community. How about murder? How about thievery? How about vandalism? Tearing up your own community for what? You got to go to these stores. You got to go. When there's something that's wrong, you call the same people that's supposed to protect you. It has no sense. The only sense you can make is God's commandments. It may seem and sound like smoke and mirrors, but it's not. Your solution been right here. Read on, come on.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day.
Baruch chapter 3, verse 2, real quick. Baruch 3 and 2, come on. I'm going to get this real quick. Because the lives of the dead Israelites, their prayers are being heard right now. That brother George Floyd, his prayers are being heard right now. The Lord hear his prayers. Why was he afflicted? Why was he being prosecuted? Why was he being murdered? Because of who he is and where he came from. Straight up. Come on, read that.
Baruch chapter 3, verse 2. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy, for thou art merciful, and have pity upon us, because we have sinned before thee, for thou endurest forever, and we pay.
Verse 4.
O Lord Almighty, thou God of Israel.
O Lord, thou mighty, the God of who?
The God of Israel.
The God of who?
The God of Israel.
This Bible is speaking to the God, the people of the God of Israel.
That's right.
The people of Israel.
That's right.
The true living God is the God of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
Plain and simple. Come on, read that again.
Hear now the prayers of the dead Israelites.
Hear the prayers of who?
The dead Israelites.
Emmett Till. Read.
And hear the prayers of the dead Israelites.
Martin Luther King. Read again.
Hear the prayers of the dead Israelites.
Malcolm X.
Hear the prayers of the dead Israelites.
George Floyd. Read.
Now hear the prayers of the dead Israelites.
Michael Brown.
Read. Hear the prayers of the dead Israelites.
We never have done this.
Right. Absolutely correct. According to the scriptures, let me see what we've done. I'm going to show you what we continue to try to do. Give me Lamentations chapter 4, verse 17. This is what we've always tried to do, and it has never given us the solution to the problem that we're in. We've always tried to ask for people that's in this land to treat us like humans. And it ain't never changed. Read that again from the top. Read.
Lamentations chapter 4, verse 17. As for us, our eyes has yet failed for our vain help.
We've looked for vain help. The brother on the phone right now, he asked a question. We've looked for vain help in America. We've looked for vain help in America. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 48. Deuteronomy 28, verse 48. You really think that the people that put you in chains are going to treat you like human beings?
Right.
We really think that the people that sat up here and raped, robbed, and murdered your nation is going to treat you like humans?
Right.
You have an idea of freedom, brother. You have an idea of freedom, sister.
Right.
We have an idea of freedom, but it ain't the right way.
Right.
Even right now, this word may be coming in one ear and not the other. It may not be what everybody else is doing, because God's ways are not seen pleasant before a lot of people. Y'all don't really want his solution. I'm going to tell you straight. You want the anger and aggression, because that's the only way you can express the conditions that you're in.
Power.
while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.